यस मुलन, आवाज येतोय का?
यस सर,
यस सर।
Within 2 minutes we'll start the lecture. Let everyone join. Okay students, we'll start the lecture. The chapter, a new chapter known as atomic structure. Okay, already an atom. Okay, and you know what are different fundamental, what are different fundamental particles of atoms? Students, what are different fundamental particles of an atom? Yes, tell me different particles of an atom. Okay, just a minute. Repeat it again. I'm audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me different fundamental particles of an atom. Are students already?
Electron and neutron.
Very good. Proton, electron, and neutron. So I'll write here electron, which is represented by symbol E. Proton, which is represented by symbol H or P. Even hydrogen is called as proton. And neutron, it is represented by symbol N. Okay, students, do you know what is the charge on electron? We can say -1, so this is a charge. What is the charge on proton?
Positive charge.
Yeah, that is +1, that is, this is charge. And neutron is chargeless, so I'll write 0. Neutron is a chargeless. Now when I am talking about mass with respect to proton and neutron, we have seen electron mass is very less, so we'll consider it as Yes, students, I am audible to everyone.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, we are talking about discovery of electron. Do you know, students, which scientist discovered the electron? Which was the scientist who discovered the electron? Students, yes. Students, J.J. Thomson. J.J. Thomson was the scientist who discovered the electron. Who discovered electron. But you know, who named as electron? Means the name was given by different scientists and discovery was done by J.J. Thomson. Name was given by Stoiny. Okay, so electrons was discovered by J.J. Thomson and it was named by Stoiny. Now, I will show you the experimental setup. I'll show you the experimental setup, how the discovery of electron was done. Okay. Yes, can you see this diagram on the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. So this is called as, students, this tube is called as discharge tube. A glass tube is there around 50 centimeter long. Okay, now you can see here two metal plates. Here, this is one metal plate, this is another metal plate. The metal plate which is attached to negative terminals, here this is a negative terminal of battery, it is called as cathode. And the metal plate which is attached to positive terminal of battery is called as anode. Okay, now, so metal plate which is attached to negative terminal, cathode. The metal plate which is attached to positive terminal is anode. Students, here very high voltage, around 10,000 volt was applied. Very high voltage around 10,000 volt was applied. Now, here you can see two vacuum pump, means from this the vacuum pump was connected, complete air was removed from this tube, and air at very low pressure was filled. What is that low pressure, students? It is 10 raised to minus 2 mm of Hg to 10 raised to minus 3 mm of Hg. So less pressure was there in this tube. Any gas was filled in this tube. So we'll just consider that hydrogen gas is filled in this tube. You can fill any gas into this tube, but the pressure should be very less. Here pressure is 10 raised to minus 2 millimeter of Hg or 10 raised to minus 3 millimeter of Hg. Do you know, students, the pressure on us is 1 atmosphere. And do you know 1 atmosphere means how much mm of Hg? Yes, any one of you?
760.
Very good. 760 mm of Hg. 1 atm means 760 mm of Hg. Means on us, the pressure is 760 mm of Hg. Now you can just see how much low pressure it is there. 10 raised to minus 2 to 10 raised to minus 3 mm of Hg. Okay, now. So we are considering that in this tube, hydrogen gas is filled, which is at very low pressure, you can fill any gas. Okay, now listen to me carefully. This is hydrogen gas, correct? Now, I am talking about hydrogen atom. If this hydrogen atom loses one electron, hydrogen will become H plus. Yes, students. What we are doing, we are removing one electron from this hydrogen. So it will become H plus. If second hydrogen also, if I take, it removes one electron, it will become H plus. And when we add this, it will be two hydrogen, means I can write H2. Two hydrogen minus two electrons will get two times H plus. Okay, now. Listen here, this is one plate, this is one plate, which is in this tube. The plate which is attached to negative terminal, students, it is called as cathode. And the plate which is attached to positive terminal is called as anode. So cathode means it is negatively charged. And anode means it is positively charged. Okay, in between hydrogen gas is there. Suppose we'll consider this is a nucleus of hydrogen. And this is outermost shell of hydrogen and it has one electron. So at very high voltage, how much is the voltage? 10,000 volt. What will happen? This gas will ionize. Ionize means what? This will strike here. This electron will be ejected. Now tell me, electron will move towards which terminal? Electron is negatively charged. It will move towards which terminal?
Cathode.
It will move towards cathode.
No, sir, anode.
Yes, it will move towards anode. Our students, oppositely charged particles attract each other. So it is moving towards anode. And students, this anode, this scientist has taken this anode as perforated. Perforated means having small holes. This plate is having small holes to it. And here, now see in the diagram. In diagram, I'll explain you. See here. This anode is perforated. And here I am. Okay, I'll use another color. See here. Students, this is called as ZNS screen. This is called as ZNS screen. Here they use, students, fluorescent material. They use fluorescent material. Our television screen is a fluorescent material. So in our television, a picture tube is there inside, which strikes that glass and then the picture is seen. So this is fluorescent material, that is ZNS. Because this anode is perforated, perforated means having small holes. The electron passes through this anode and it strikes this ZNS screen and this ZNS screen glows. Can you see in this diagram it is written green glow? Can you see here it is a green glow?
Yes, sir.
Are you, because this electrons you cannot see. So once it strikes here, once it strikes this ZNS screen, it will glow. And from that we have understood that something is coming from cathode, because it is coming through anode, sorry, coming towards anode, because backside of anode ZNS screen is there. So they understood that some rays are coming through cathode. So electrons were initially named as cathode rays. Why cathode rays? Because they are coming from cathode and they are striking at anode. Okay, did you understand how these electrons were discovered? Okay, again I'll repeat the experiments here. The tube which you can see on your screen is discharge tube. It is around 50 centimeter long. Two electrodes are inside it. One is cathode, one is anode. Cathode is which one is attached to negative terminal, and anode which is attached to positive terminal. A very low pressure gas is filled into it. Suppose we are considering hydrogen gas. You can take any gas. If you are considering hydrogen gas, hydrogen loses one electron to form H plus, and H2 gas loses two electrons to form 2H plus. So electrons are ejected at very high voltage. How much is the voltage? 10,000 volt. At very high voltage, this electron which is in the outermost shell is ejected. Electrons are having negative charge, so it will go towards anode. But this anode is perforated. Perforated means having small holes, because the rays we cannot see by our eyes. So backside of anode, ZNS screen was there. ZNS is fluorescent material. When anything strikes on it, it glows. So a green glow was seen. So then scientists understood, okay, something is coming from cathode towards anode. That's why electrons were initially named as cathode rays. Electrons were initially named as cathode rays. Did you understand this experiment?
Yes, sir.
Now we are going to see some properties of cathode rays. We are going to see some properties of cathode rays. This property, students, it's theoretical question is asked sometime. So look at this property. Cathode rays starts from cathode and move towards anode. Is this statement correct? Cathode rays means, students, are negatively charged. It will move from cathode towards anode. All right, just now we have seen the experiment.
Yes, sir.
See here, in this experiment, you can see something is coming from cathode and moving towards anode. And this anode is perforated. Perforated means we can say porous, having small holes into it. So this electron will penetrate this cathode and glow the ZNS screen, which is kept just back of it. Second point. These rays are not visible. Students, these rays are not visible. So how we understood that these rays are coming from cathode?
From green glow.
Yes, from green glow. On what that glow was there? Yes, definitely your answer is correct, from green glow. But on what material that green glow was there?
ZNS screen.
Very good, ZNS screen. And that is fluorescent material. Fluorescent material means which glows. Fluorescent material means which glows. Array, if you see, some colors are fluorescent. Have you seen fluorescent colors? Or sometime I think so, you get some hand bands which are fluorescent. At night they will shine.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Usually you use that wristbands which glows at night. So they are made up of fluorescent material. So these rays are not visible, students, but we can see their behavior. We can see their behavior with the help of fluorescent material. with the help of fluorescent material. Third point. They travel in straight line. Means I am talking about cathode rays, and cathode rays is nothing but electrons, but that time they were not knowing the name of it, so they said cathode rays. They travel in a straight line with high velocity, students, very high velocity. With high velocity is around 10 raised to 7 centimeter per second. 10 raised to 7 centimeter per second. So the speed was very high. Okay, fourth one. They produce heat energy when collide with matter. Okay, suppose see here, this is the negative terminal which is cathode, and this is a positive terminal which is called as anode. So we know something is coming from this cathode and going towards anode. If some material is kept here, students, this cathode rays will strike it, and it will make this the substance, it will make it heated or it will make it hot. That means it indicates that whatever is striking on this, it produces this heat energy when it collides with this matter. This is a matter or some obstacle we are keeping in its path. That time we have seen its temperature increases. That indicates something which I will tell you afterwards, that indicates the particle nature. Up till now it was just imagined that is there is a wave, but something is striking it. Something is striking it and producing some heat. That means some particle will be present in this electron. Then, fifth point. In absence of electrical and magnetic field. In absence of electrical and magnetic field, they travel in a straight line. Now, what will happen in electric and magnetic field? We are going to discuss it. In the absence of electric and magnetic field, they travel in straight line. This was the fifth point. Sixth point. In presence of electrical and magnetic field, their behavior is similar to negative particle. Similar to negative particle. What it means here? Okay, this is a negative terminal, so this is a cathode. And this is a positive terminal, so this is an anode. So some rays are coming from cathode, and they travel in a straight line in absence of electric and magnetic field. So if electric field, if I'll keep it like this, and okay, this is a positive, this is a negative terminal, and this is a positive terminal. In this direction, if I'll keep the electricity, this it is seen that this rays bends towards positive terminal. It bends towards positive terminal. Now it bends towards positive terminal means what will be the charge on that cathode rays?
Negative.
Because that's why I written it is similar to negative particles. Then they understood that something which is coming from cathode, actually they are not sure. they are not sure because this discovery was done by J.J. Thomson and name was given by Stoiny. So they were not sure that this is an electron or what is charged on it. So by different experiment, they understood because it is deflected towards positive terminal, means something which is coming out from cathode is negative. They understood that it is negative. Then this is very important property. This rays can affect photographic plates. Photographic plates. Now, what is a photographic plate, students? It is a plate which is coated with silver bromide. It is a plate which is coated with silver bromide. Have you seen in some old movies that initially big cameras were there? Nowadays we get digital camera, students, but initially photographic plates, a big camera, they were using. So that big camera, there was a photographic plate. So this photographic plate was coated with AGBR, and when you put this cathode rays on it, this, it will affect, means it will break Ag and Br. You know halogens has 7 electrons in outermost shell, so like this it will break, and if you take this electron, then Br will become minus. So you just consider that it will affect the photographic plate. Photographic plate is nothing but a plate which is coated with AgBr. Initially they used to use for photography in old cameras. And last two points are left. See here. This rays ionize the gases. Okay. Now, in this experiment, which gas we consider? We consider hydrogen gas. But initially only I told you that any gas you can consider. Suppose if I consider this hydrogen gas, will get ionized into H plus two times. How it happens? This H loses one electron to form H plus. Again, one more hydrogen loses one electron to form H plus, means ultimately, okay, just a minute, students. Okay, students, look at this point. So this hydrogen gas, it has ionized because it has converted into ion. So if I'll add this H plus H will form H2, because hydrogen is always diatomic. It loses two electrons and it produces two H plus, two ions of hydrogen after losing two electrons. So this cathode rays has the property to ionize the gases. So it can be any gas in this. Now, the main point, this ninth point is very important, students. From here, many times question is asked. The nature of cathode rays is independent of first nature of cathode and second the gas taken in discharge tube. Gas taken in the discharge tube. Now here I am underlining, it is independent nature of cathode. Now nature of cathode, now students, cathode you take of any material, still the same rays are produced. See here what I am telling you, see this diagram. Okay, look at this guy. Students, this cathode you take of any material, because this plate is not cathode, students. When it is attached to negative terminal, that time it becomes cathode. So you take this plate of any material, whether it is of iron, zinc, copper, whichever plate you take, the same rays are produced. And second, it was independent on the nature of gas taken. Now I have considered hydrogen gas. If you take oxygen gas, then also it will produce electron, because the electron is the fundamental particle of all atoms. Students, in all gases, electrons will be present. In every element, electron is present, correct?
Yes.
So if I replace the oxygen, hydrogen by oxygen, or oxygen by nitrogen, will it produce electrons only?
Yes.
I do not understand. Or instead of hydrogen gas, if I take nitrogen gas, will it produce electrons?
Yes.
Definitely it will produce electron. If you take oxygen gas, definitely it will take oxygen gas. Oxygen gas will produce electrons. So producing electron doesn't depend upon the electrode which is taken or the gas which is filled in that tube. You fill any gas, till electron will be produced, because electron is the fundamental particle of an all atom. In all atoms in periodic table, you see electrons are present. So you take any gas in this discharge tube, still it will produce electron. You take any metal as a cathode, still it will produce electron. That time they were not knowing electron, that time they were saying cathode rays. Okay, now students, after this can you see this one more diagram?
Yes sir.
Yes
sir. Yes, I am talking the diagram which is in the center. Okay, now this was also okay, now the same experiment was done, that is of discharge tube. Now when there is absence of electric and magnetic field, this rays travel in the straight line and hits the point B. Because in one of the property we have seen, cathode rays travel in a straight line in absence of electric and magnetic field. So it will strike this point, that is point B, which is in straight line. Now, whenever electric field was applied, students, when electric field was applied, can you see downside? It is a positive terminal here. So it is deflected towards point C. So point C, this is because of electrical field. That means we understood that whatever is coming from cathode is a negative particle, because it is deflecting towards positive particles. It is deflecting towards positive terminal. And finally, they balanced Okay, when magnetic field was applied, it goes towards A. Then what they did, they balanced electric and magnetic field. They balanced electric and magnetic field and they adjusted that point to B. And they did some calculations, students. This calculation is not there in our syllabus. They did some calculation and they got the formula. Which formula they got? E upon M. E upon M is minus 1.7558 into 10 raised to 11 coulomb per kg. What is this E, students? This E is the charge on electron, charge on electron. And this M is mass of electron. So who found this E by M ratio? E by M ratio was found by J.J. Thomson. And what is this ratio? Minus 1.75588 into 10 raised to 11 coulomb per kg. For this is the charge of one electron, students. This is charge of one electron. And this M is charge of, sorry, mass of one electron. So this value will be fixed for everyone, students. This value will be 1.588 into 10 raised to 11 coulomb per kg. Yes. So this value was found by J.J. Thomson. Now, after that, students, charge on electron. Charge on electron means this E, I am talking about this E, was found by one scientist whose name was Mulliken's. Whose name was Mulliken. Mulliken oil drop experiment. What he found? He found the charge on the electron. How he found charge on electron? Here one diagram is there. Look at this diagram carefully. In this bulb, they filled oil. And like how we spray perfume, like this, the oil was sprayed here. So they got this small droplets of oil. A small hole was made in this, a small hole. Now this plate is positive terminal. This plate is negative terminal. So this oil droplet passes through this hole. Okay, this is the hole. This oil droplet passes through this hole. And can you see like this zigzag line is there? Actually, here it is the source of X-rays. Source of X-rays. Now, what is X-rays does? X-rays has the property to ionize the gas. X-rays has the property to ionize the gas. So what happened? Suppose here some gas is present in this chamber. In this chamber, some gas is present. So this gas, the nucleus will be there. And here electron will be there. So this X-rays, if it strikes this electron will be free. And this the electron will be adsorbed by this oil droplet. So this oil droplet is having electron in it now. Because of this X-rays, the gas inside that chamber gets ionized and the electrons are free. The electrons will stick to that oil now. Now, can I say this oil is a now negative terminal? Because electron is there in that oil. Now, look at this plate. Upside, there is a positive plate. Downside, it is a negative plate. Now, due to gravity, now this oil droplet is having negative because it is having electron in it. And due to gravity, this oil droplet will come downside. But which plate is there upside positive plate, downside which plate is there negative plate? Can anybody tell me this oil droplet will be attracted towards which plate?
Positive plate.
Positive means gravitational force, it is pulling it down, and this plate, it is pulling it up. Are you understanding? Because upside you see positive plate is there. This is the positive plate. This gravitation is pulling the oil droplet downside, and this positive plate, it is pulling oil droplet upwards. So this oil droplet, for some time, it will become stationary. Stationary means fixed at one place, because these both the forces are balanced, gravitational force and the force because of this positive terminal, we can say it as electrostatic force. Force between oppositely charged particle is called as electrostatic force. So electrostatic force and gravitational force, if they are balanced, this oil droplet here, it will become steady. This oil droplet here, it will become steady, and the observer can see from this microscope. And then this scientist studied. Oil droplet carefully, and he did some, and then he found the charge on electron. He found 1 point. Everyone need to remember this value, because charge, this is charge on one electron students. This is charge on one electron. So he did some calculation. We are not concerned with that calculation, but he got value 1.6 into 10 to minus 19. This value was found by scientists as the Mulliken's oil drop experiment. And you know, students, E by M AJ Thompson. Okay, without looking into the notebook, can anybody tell me what was the value of E by M? What was the value of E by M?
1.7.
Minus 1.7.
Pi.
8820 into 10 to 2.
Coulomb per kg.
Yes, very good. We got charge on the electron, and we have E by M. So can we find mass of electron from here? Because E by M, we have minus 1.75 double 8 into 10 raised to 11 coulomb per kg, and charge on this electron, we have 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. So the value of M we can find. Sir, how to find this value of M? Just substitute the value. So M is equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb divided by minus 1.75 double 8 into 10 raised to 11 coulomb per kg. And finally, they got the mass of electron. Now, in previous chapter, I told you mass of electron. Can anybody remember mass of electron? I told you in kg as well as gram.
9.1.
Very good. 9.1 into, yes. 10 raised to?
10 raised to minus 31.
Very good. Minus 31. That was value in kg, correct? So if you do this calculation, students, if you do this calculation, you will get this value. And if I want it in gram, then if the value
minus
if
28.
I want in
minus
gram,
27.
Minus 28 gram.
0.1 into 10 raised to minus 28 grams. So students, most of the time in exam, direct mass of electron will be asked. So mass of electron, you need to remember, it is 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kg, or minus, sorry, not minus, 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 21, 28 grams, minus 28 grams. And if it in kg, it is 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kg. This will be the mass of electron. So now you might have understood from where we got this mass of electron, because E by M ratio was found by J.J. Thomson. That value was minus 1.7588 into 10 raised to 11 coulomb per kg. Then charge on electron was found by Mulliken's. That charge was minus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. And from that, they found the mass of electron, and they got mass of electron, that is 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kg. Okay. Now, students, if this mass, if I want in AMU in unit, if this mass, if I want in AMU in unit, can anybody tell me one AMU is equal to how much grams? Previous chapter we learned this one AMU is equal to how much grams?
1.66 into 10 raised to minus 20.
Into 10 raised to
minus 24.
Very good, minus 24 grams. And then what is the mass of electron in grams? 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 28 grams. So can you found how much AMU it is? So if you cross multiply it, if you cross multiply it, mass of electron in AMU, that will be 9.1 into 10 raised to 28 grams upon 1.66 into 10 raised to 24 grams. If you solve this, students, if you solve this, it will be 0.0005486 AMU. Now you might be understanding, so small it is, 0.0005486. So that's why we were considering that mass of electron is zero. Because you see, this value in AMU is 0.0005486. That's why we were considering this as zero. Okay. Now this is the concept for you, students. Can you find mass of one mole electron? Mass of one mole electron. Can you tell me how we are going to find it? Mass of one mole of electron. Can I say molar mass of electron? How to find it? Okay, can you tell me mass of one electron? Point 1 into 10 raised to? Students, molar mass means mass of one mole. And so can I multiply it by 6.02 into 10 raised to 23? Because this is nothing but one mole. This is any Avogadro's number, but one mole. So finally, when you do calculation, you get 5.5 into 10 raised to minus this value. Always you remember this value. No need minus 4 gram. So students, can you convert this into kg? Yes. Yes, Pranjal, how to convert this gram into kg? Yes, very good. Yes, Pranav has given the correct answer. So the value is 5.5 into 10 raised to minus 7 kg. Yes. If I want to convert this into milligrams, then milligrams means divided by 1000. So can I write 0.55 milligram? Milligram.
Yes.
Again, 0.55 milligram, because I'll divide it by 1000. So these three zeros cancel, three zeros cancel, minus one is left. So this point will go out. So it is 0.55 milligrams. So always remember this. Okay. So if you want to compare how small this value is there, how small this value is there, students, mass of hydrogen. Mass of hydrogen in AMU. Mass of hydrogen in AMU is 1.008. So approximately we take it as 1. Mass of hydrogen in AMU is 1.008. And mass of electron in AMU. Now only we have found it. 0.0005486 AMU, and this is AMU. And if you calculate these students, you get 1837 means hydrogen is 1837 times heavier than electron. Array, first of all, this hydrogen is the first element of periodic table. It is so small, and hydrogen is 1837 times more mass than electrons. So you might just consider electron will be how much less mass. Sometime directly they will ask you question, hydrogen is how much times heavier than electron. So it is 1837 times heavier than electron. First of all, you can consider hydrogen is the lightest gas in the periodic table. And it is heavier than electron. How much times? 1837 times. So electron will be so small in weight. That's why we consider it at zero. Did you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So again, before going front, we'll revise some values. Okay, we'll revise some values. You need to tell me, okay? Who will tell me E by M? Students, with discussion only you'll understand this value.
1.7588 into 10 raised to 11 per kg.
Given by J.J. Thompson, correct? Charge on electron given by Millikan's. Will tell me charge on one electron.
-1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹.
Very good. -1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. This was given by scientist Millikan. Millikan oil drop experiment. Okay. So from this, if you do some calculation, you will get mass of electron. Who will tell me the mass of electron?
9.1 × 10⁻³ kg.
-31 kg. Or if it is gram, if you want to write, it is 9.1 × 10⁻²⁸ grams. Yes. So students, these values you need to remember. Can you tell me, students, mass of electron in AMU? In AMU, how much is its mass?
0.0005486 AMU.
Very good. 5, 4, 86, very good. It's a mu. Mass of hydrogen in AMU is how much times greater than electrons? Mass of hydrogen in AMU is how much times greater than electrons?
1837.
Very good. 1837. Students, I am telling you these values because straightforward question is asked in exam. JE Mains straightforward question is asked. Mass of hydrogen in AMU is how much times greater than mass of electron in AMU? So you need to tell 1837 times. Okay. Next one. Mass of 1 mole electron, students. 1 mole electron. Yes. 5.5 × 10⁻⁴. I think so. -4 grams it was.
Gram.
And it is 5.5 × 10⁻⁷ kg. Correct. And yes. In milligram, it was 0.55 milligrams. Okay, students, once you just read that experiment, only these values you need to remember, students. No one is going to ask how is that experiment, how much long that tube is there. No one is going to ask, students, like this question J will never ask. They will ask these values. So first theoretical part, yes, students, first theoretical part will finish earlier. Then after that, we'll try to, I will try when you are, internet connection is stable, I'll try to teach you on board, but initially all theoretical part, discovery of electron, proton, neutron, will finish it. Okay, so now one more concept is there, students, which is very much important. Previous questions are asked on this concept, that is a mass of moving electron. Up till now, we have seen the mass of electron at the rest. Now we'll see mass of moving electron. One formula is there for it, students. Mass of moving electron is equal to mass of electron at the rest. Now only we have seen what is the mass of one electron, that 9.1 × 10⁻²⁸ grams. So that is the mass of the electron at the rest, means stable position. But we want a mass of moving electron. So divided by under root 1 upon V square upon C square. What is this V? This is velocity of electron. This C is speed of light. Now tell me, students. Now tell me, if V, velocity of electron, if velocity of electron is equal to velocity of light, if velocity of electron is equal to velocity of light, what will be its mass? Listen to my question properly. If the velocity of electron is equal to velocity of light, means V is equal to C, what will be the mass of moving electron? Yes. Again, I'm repeating my question. You have a formula in front of you. Mass of moving electron is the mass of electron at the rest divided by under root 1 minus v square upon c square, where v is the velocity of electron, c is the velocity of light. My question to you is very straightforward. If velocity of electron is equal to velocity of light, what will be its mass?
Infinite.
Yes, its mass will be infinite. Same question I'm asking here. This v and c is equal, so it will become 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. So anything divided by 0, its mass will be infinite. Other students, this question is asked, when the velocity of electron is equal to velocity of light, mass of electron will be infinity. Infinite. Okay. Students, if the velocity of electron is too much smaller than velocity of light, if velocity of electron is too much smaller than velocity of light, what will be the mass of electron? If velocity of electron is too much smaller than velocity of light, here, students, this v is very small. This v is very small, and this c is very large. So, students, this product will be nearly equal to zero. So, 1 minus 0 will be 1. So, can I say mass of electron will be mass of electron at rest? Here, students, here only these two types of question. Yes. Yes, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, again, I'll repeat. Mass of moving electron, you need to just remember the formula. That is mass of electron at the rest divided by under root 1 minus v square upon c square. If v is equal to c, mass of that electron will be infinite. And if v is very much smaller than c, because velocity of light is too much greater, then mass of moving electron will be mass of electron at the rest. Only these two concepts you need to remember. Okay. So, students, this is enough for today's lecture. Okay, tell me, students, who discovered electron?
J.J.
Thomson.
J.J. Thomson discovered
it.
Who named it?
Steiner
named it. What was that experiment? What was that tube called, students? What was that tube called?
Discharge tube.
Yes, very good. Discharge tube. Students, you know, thunderstorm, nowadays rainy season is there. Tumhala maite veej jase kadkadtat. So same, that time this discharge tube experiment were very much famous. That scientist tried to make same setup in the lab. Javes dhag ekamekala dash hotat, tyaves khup jasta light ये होती तेज एक्सपेरिमेंट साइंटिस्ट ना लैब मध्ये केले त्याला त्यांनी नाव दिलं डिस्चार्ज ट्यूब एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट्स व्हाई दे प्रोड्यूस दे आर गिवन सो हाई वोल्टेज व्हाट वाज द वोल्टेज इन दैट डिस्चार्ज ट्यूब
10,000 वोल्टेज
वेरी गुड 10,000 वोल्ट एंड द इलेक्ट्रोड व्हिच इज अटैच्ड टू नेगेटिव टर्मिनल वाज कॉल्ड एनोड करेक्ट The electrode which was attached to negative terminal was called anode. Is it correct?
No,
sir. It is cathode. Yes, I wanted to see whether you are attentive or what. Yes, it's cathode. The negative terminal which is attached to that electrode, it is cathode, and which is attached to positive terminal, it is called as anode. Any gas with very low pressure was filled, students. Very low pressure. Students, what was that pressure? Yes. How much was that pressure?
Ten raised to minus two mm
of Hg to 10^-3 mm of Hg. The scientists do not want this. Yes. 10^-2 to 10^-3. Just to attract each other. That's why at this very highest coming from cathode strikes this electron, the electron will be ejected, an electron will move towards anode, but this anode is perforated. Perforated means having small holes in it, and backside of it one screen was there. Which is that screen?
ZnX screen.
Fluorescent.
Yes, ZnX screen. And it was a fluorescent material, because this cathode rays are not visible to our eyes, but if this cathode ray strikes to this ZnX screen, this ZnX screen will glow. And then they understood that some rays are coming from cathode. That's why initially they named it as cathode rays. So electrons were initially called as cathode rays because they come from cathode. They come from cathode. Now, students, just 2 minutes. This is cathode. This is anode. Okay, here hydrogen gas is there. Here electron is there. So this is the negative terminal. So this is a positive terminal. Here ZnX screen is there. So this, the rays comes here, it strikes this electron. This electron moves here. Electron, it is negative, so it will move towards anode. Students, this positive, where it will move? This positive. Okay, electron moves here. This positive moves towards
negative.
Cathode.
Cathode, correct? No. And this positive, students, what is there in a nucleus? Or what is present in the nucleus?
Proton, neutron. Proton.
Proton, neutron, and neutron is chargeless. Students, just I want to tell you one thing. ZnX screen was placed here. Say they got the discovery of electron. If Zn was placed here, they might have got the discovery of proton. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Again, I'll repeat here. ZnX screen, ये देखो ये ZnX screen anode के पीछे लगाया गया था, तब उनको discovery हो गई electron की. If ZnX screen was placed, अगर हम कैथोड के पीछे डालते तो कैथोड के पास भी तो ये प्रोटॉन जा रहे थे, तो अब कौन सी स्क्रीन ग्लो होती? जो कैथोड के पीछे वो स्क्रीन ग्लो होती. मींस एक ही एक्सपेरिमेंट में दोनों पार्टिकल मिल जाते, हमको दोनों पार्टिकल मिल जाते, इलेक्ट्रॉन भी मिल जाता और प्रोटॉन भी मिल जाता. पर जो इस साइंटिस्ट ने किया था, जे थॉमसन ने, तो वो ZnX स्क्रीन उसने एनोड के पीछे लगाई थी. तो कल हम यही एक्सपेरिमेंट देखेंगे, पर अभी ZnX स्क्रीन कहां लगा देंगे? कहां लगा देंगे? प्रोटॉन के लिए, प्रोटॉन के लिए, प्रोटॉन की डिस्कवरी के लिए ZnX स्क्रीन कहां लगा देंगे हम अभी? कैथोड के पीछे. कहां लगा देंगे? कैथोड के
पीछे.
पीछे. तो ये दूसरे साइंटिस्ट ने डिस्कवर किया था, पर मुझे ये बताने का है आपको, जब इलेक्ट्रॉन की डिस्कवरी हो गई थी उसी टाइम प्रोटॉन भी इजेक्ट हो गया था. तो उस साइंटिस्ट ने अगर दोनों साइड ZnX स्क्रीन लगाई दी होती, तो उसी ने ही दोनों पार्टिकल्स डिस्कवर किए होते। समझ में आ गया?
यस
सर।
तो कल हम देखेंगे डिस्कवरी ऑफ प्रोटॉन एंड न्यूट्रॉन, पर ये जे जे थॉमसन ने ही डिस्कवर किया होता अगर उसने कैथोड के पीछे ZNS स्क्रीन लगाई गई होती और एनोड के पीछे भी ZNS, अगर दोनों साइड ZNS स्क्रीन होती तो दोनों साइड भी ग्लो होता, तो उसे मत उसको वही से मालूम होता तो एक पार्टिकल नेगेटिव है और एक पार्टिकल पॉजिटिव है, तो इसका मतलब एनोड में पॉजिटिव सॉरी एटम में पॉजिटिव पार्टिकल भी है और निगेटिव पार्टिकल भी है। तो कल हम देखेंगे डिस्कवरी ऑफ प्रोटॉन। मैंने आपको सिर्फ आइडिया दे दी, कल हम क्या एक्सपेरिमेंट देखने वाले, वही डिस्चार्ज एक्सपेरिमेंट देखने वाले, पर अभी हम स्क्रीन कहाँ लगा देंगे, कैथोड के पीछे लगा देंगे। आया समझ में? मीन्स कल हम 5 मिनट में ही एक्सपेरिमेंट देख सकते हैं। आया समझ में?
यस सर।
क्योंकि हमने डिस्कवरी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एकदम डिटेल में देख लिया, तो डिस्कवरी ऑफ प्रोटॉन और न्यूट्रॉन वो तो बहुत छोटा कंसेप्ट है, वो तो हम इजीली कल देख लेंगे, क्योंकि इलेक्ट्रॉन अगर एनोड के तरफ जाता है तो प्रोटॉन कहाँ जाएगा, कैथोड के तरफ। प्रोटॉन कहाँ से जा रहा है, एनोड से। सो प्रोटॉन को हम एनोड रेज कह सकते हैं क्या? जैसे इलेक्ट्रॉन को हम कैथोड रेज कहते हैं क्योंकि वो कैथोड से एनोड की तरफ जा रहा है, तो प्रोटॉन को हम एनोड रेज कह सकते हैं क्या, क्योंकि वो एनोड से कैथोड की तरफ जा रहा है।
Yes, sir.
तो sometime very simple question they will ask, anode rays are called as, तो आपको तुरंत समझ में आना चाहिए एनोड पॉजिटिव है, प्रोटॉन भी पॉजिटिव होता है, तो पॉजिटिव निगेटिव तरफ जाता है, तो प्रोटॉन एनोड रेज मतलब प्रोटॉन ही होता है, और कैथोड रेज तो कैथोड निगेटिव होता है तो इलेक्ट्रॉन भी निगेटिव होता है, तो कैथोड रेज मीन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन ही होता है। आया समझ में?
Yes,
okay, yes, I think so you might have understood today's lecture very nicely.
Yes sir.
पर आप अगर yes, मैंने दो अगर मैंने दो दिन बाद फिर से वो values आपको पूछ लिया E by M charge on electron mass of electron, तो आप बता सकते हो क्या?
Yes sir.
Suddenly I'll be asking in between like tomorrow or day after tomorrow, suddenly I'll be asking what is the mass of one mole of electron. बच्चों अगर आपको ये values ठीक ठाक मालूम हो गई तो आप question में direct tick कर सकते हो, आपको values find करने की कुछ जरूरत नहीं। कुछ बच्चे मुझे बोलेंगे सर mass of one mole of electron हम निकल सकते हैं क्योंकि mass of one electron हमको मालूम है 9.1 × 10⁻²⁸, उसको हम Avogadro number से multiply कर देंगे। अरे बच्चों पर वहाँ उतना time नहीं होता, तो अगर मुझे पहले से ही मालूम होगा तो वो वैल्यू होती है 5.5 × 10⁻⁴ kg, तो मेरा आंसर बहुत जल्दी टिक हो जाएगा। तो ये वैल्यू आपको आनी ही चाहिए किसी भी हालत में। तो मैं सडनली कल या परसों के लेक्चर में सडनली नाम लेकर पूछ लूंगा, किसका भी नाम लूंगा, उसको ये वैल्यूज आनी ही चाहिए। सो नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, हियर आई एम एंडिंग द लेक्चर। डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड द लेक्चर?
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Okay, yes, thank you sir. Students, thank you.
Yes sir.
Thank you sir.
Okay, thank you. For now it's not sure up till now when the college will reopen. As soon as government tells us, the first day itself will open the college. As soon as government announces, you will also get to know that in new channel, as soon as they announces, the first day will start the college. Because we all want you in the college. As soon as we get the permission, we'll start the college. Okay?
Okay, sir.